Hello, and welcome to episode 10 of my Rising World tutorial Let's Play series. This episode will be on making a scythe and a sledgehammer, and I want to show you what they do. Before that though, let's go plant this cotton, which I didn't manage to do in the last episode. And the cotton I shall put at this far end. I'm leaving all that middle section for the workstations and other things that I'll be making. Let's just move this back a bit. So let's get my rake. This is something no doubt you'll be continually doing, is expanding your ground land around your settlement so you can just plant more and more crops as you find them and as they're introduced into the game. Remember, Rising World is still in alpha stage, so there's still going to be loads of stuff added to the game. It's just how long it takes. So, you know, with all the other games you play, you can keep coming back to Rising World and see something new, hopefully, that's arrived with it. When there's been enough updates, that's what I will do. I'm going to get to possibly 20 episodes with Rising World, pull it on pause, and then when there's enough new updates, I can show you them updates in future episodes. Let's turn that light off. It's a bit bright to see what I'm doing. Okay, let's hack this tree down. Always good to get more wood. Okay, let's switch back to the rake. Give ourselves a bit of room for a cotton plantation. You remember in episode 1, I picked some hemp. So there is also hemp you can find and grow. But of course I lost it because that tiger decided to kill me, or one of the tigers. Or maybe it was me that killed me by dropping into that deep hole, but never mind. Okay, that hopefully is enough room. Let's now hoe. See, this is the beautiful thing about this game. Everything you do don't take long at all. I mean, just a few minutes and I've transformed a hill into the perfect farmland. Absolutely beautiful. That's why I say you'll be playing this when you're stressed out or you just need to chill and relax. This is perfect because there is no stress with Rising World. It's all just beautiful fun. Fun, fun, fun. Is that not why we play games? Okay, right, I've got a nice big area now for cotton. Here's my cotton plantation. So, cotton's on number 3. Let's get a plant in. And maybe I can play the Lonnie Donegan song, picking cotton. Or maybe not, actually. I'll be copyrighted if I did. But it's a shame, because that's a really beautiful song. Okay, cotton is not that big a plant, but again, I just want to make sure I space them enough apart. Like so. I'm sure in the future the amount of wool you get from a sheep is going to be nerfed, because you get 32 from each sheep. Considering that you only get 4 cotton from each plant, you can see that you get a ton of wool from the sheep, so I don't think that they'll probably keep that up. I imagine they'll pull it to a lot less, maybe 4 even. For now though, you can get a ton of wool from sheep. I know my fields aren't in perfect alignment. It's because I'm trying to rush. I don't want you to spend too much time watching me plant. But for some of you, of course, I know you'd like to watch this, so that's why I'm showing it. I don't want to off camera build up my whole settlement so the next video you see everything's done. I'm trying to take you step by step through my process of making my base and everything else. Right, there we go, two rows of cotton, that's good enough for me. Right, let's get to what this episode is actually about, making a scythe and a sledgehammer, and then I can demonstrate their usefulness. Okay, for this I'm going to need iron, and four should be enough. Let's go see. Okay, so we're going to begin with the anvil, as you know, so we'll press the F key on that, and let's go to components. So we need a scythe blade, one ingot, that's cool, let's craft. So that's done, and a sledgehammer head, two iron ingots, so we'll create that. Okay, now that we've got them, we'll go to the workbench, and it's on tools already, but that's what you choose, tools. Now we want scythe, so we need four sticks, so we're going to need to make some lumber, no, sticks. So back to resources, sticks. We aren't going to need a great deal, 20 should suffice. Okay, back to tools, scythe, there you go, good to go. Let's create that. Now we want to make a sledgehammer, so we needed another stick. You see, not many resources you need. This isn't a game where you're going to have to go grinding hours and hours on for the resources. You just need a few, so it's cool. Right, so there we go. We got a scythe, we got a sledgehammer. What good are they to us? Are they even going to be good for what you want to, for your playstyle? It might be you'll never use them. Well, let's try and show you whether you will use them or not. Okay, the scythe is very much like the sickle. It will cut a bigger swathe of grass, but the difference between the scythe and the sickle, using the sickle, so let's show you, let's not just waffle about it, let's actually demonstrate this. So first I'm going to use the sickle to cut some grass. When you use the sickle on the grass, you'll notice you get grass put into your pocket. So if you right click, see I got two blades of grass, let's get some more. And I got another blade, let's get a bit more. I got grass. Right, what do you do with the blades of grass? So let's go into the pocket, there's the blades of grass, let's put them in place of the scythe. Okay, highlight the grass, then highlight a patch of ground, as you can see by that square. Right click, and you see, it plants the grass. And that's how you can have a nice, beautiful grass lawn in front of your house. But we don't want that at the moment, because this is all going to be for other purposes. So that's why you would use the sickle on the grass. Next, let's look at the scythe. The scythe will not give us no grass. It will just cut a bigger patch of grass. So right click. You see, we don't get any of the resources, but it cuts a bigger area of grass. So we can, you can see what you're doing. So maybe this is the tool you want to use for trimming your lawn. When your grass grows too high, you'll use your scythe to go around and trim it all back down. Oh, there's a bit of crop. Let's use the sickle. There we go, we've got some potatoes. So that's what the sickle does for you. It will cut your lawns nice and quickly because it gives a bigger area than this sickle, but it will not give you any blades of grass for planting. Okay, let's put the light back on, pressing the L key. So you get the idea, and if I can cut a big enough patch, you'll see the effect and how cool it looks. Right, okay. Oh, don't want to chop the tree down with it. Don't even know if you can chop a tree down with it. Okay, so there we go. Do you see that? Now you can see it's nicely cut short grass. So it's not removed the grass completely. It's just trimmed it so it looks tidier. If the ground was flat, I'm sure it would look nicer, but it's like a lumpy hill. Anyway, you get the idea behind the sickle. It cuts a bigger area of grass for you, but it doesn't remove it to soil texture like the rake would do. It trims it up nicely, a bit like trimming your beard or your moustache, if you've got one. Anyway, so let's look at the sledgehammer next and what that does for us. So let's go into my pocket. Let's put the sledgehammer there. Okay, now the sledgehammer, the rake is how you know how you, that the rake is how you terraform the earth. Okay, that's what the rake is for. You know that. I've shown you that in previous episode. The sledgehammer is the equivalent for working with rock. Now, unlike the rake can lower and raise land, as you know. But the sledgehammer will only lower the rock. It cannot raise it. It doesn't make any sense that it would raise it. Well, I'm not saying that the rake makes sense raising it, but the difference between the rake lowering and raising the ground is the sledgehammer will only lower the rock. So let's go show you. Now, I am going to need to find somewhere to do a lot of mining. I'm not sure if it's such a wise idea heading into the cold area, because there's a chance of seeing a polar bear. So, you know what, I'm not going to stray into that area, not until I've got a sword at least to defend myself with. So for now, maybe I should just dig a mine in my property here. What do you think? Should I just start a mine here? Yeah, let's do that. So let's get my pickaxe. We'll put that as number one, the sledgehammer as number two, and we're going to need food, because as we mine, we're going to use lots of food up. And so, yeah, let's do the mine just here. Them flowers can definitely go. And we'll have it right near my water. Do you hear that plump as it went into the water? How funny is that? Okay, so the mine can go, yeah, just here. Now, unlike other games, if I dig below the surface next to the water is not going to stream in. I don't know if that's something that they will do in the future, but as it stands at the moment, the water will stop just there. Do you see? The water's just like floating there. It's not going to fill up my mine. So I haven't got to worry about that, which is good. Lump. Okay, there we go. So we got a good start. Let's now mine this in. And maybe in the future I can make my entrance a bit more fancy, because it's just going to look pretty rough at the moment. I'll work it out as I go. Okay, now of course for now we just want to head down. Not too steep an angle, but enough that we can easily walk in and out. And let's see, how level is that? I want to try and get it sort of level. Oh, here we go. Rock is upon us. So I'll be able to demonstrate the sledgehammer. I love the mining in Rising World. Absolutely love it. You can see why. It's just like you choose a spot, start mining, and it's just the way it removes it and the way you're able to make to such fine mines. It's beautiful. Love it. Okay, so all the time I'm going deeper and deeper, because I don't want to ruin my ground above. It's not going to cave in on me. We don't have to do any supports or worry about anything like that. We can just have mining joy. This is just a beautiful game to play. This is the game to play when you want to relax, chill, and just have some fun. Oh, look at that. I found some ore. I wonder what it is. Is it going to be lovely to me and give me some iron? Oh, there's the timer, but you know what? I need to still demonstrate the sledgehammer. No, don't go shouting at me. I've tried to do this as quick as I can. Let's eat a tomato, because I don't want to start dying. Right, let's carry on mining. Oh, iron. Splendid. Oh, this is beautiful. It looks like a mother lode. Right, so what I want to do now, let's try and build a big room so I can demonstrate the sledgehammer for you. So just give me a moment to dig out a bit of, mine out a bit of space here. At least I've got plenty of storage space now, so I don't have to worry about mining too many items. In the ceiling, which I didn't want to do. Okay, let's mine this. It'd be funny, wouldn't it, if the ceiling collapsed down on me? I know it's not, you know, well, it better not, but wouldn't that be funny? Right, okay, so let's mine some more out, and then hopefully I'll be able to demonstrate the sledgehammer. Right, okay, so hopefully now I can demonstrate the sledgehammer. Notice I've purposely left some lumps in the ground there. So, if we switch to the sledgehammer, no, not a block of iron, if we switch to the actual sledgehammer, which is number 2, there you go. Now, watch what it does to the lump sticking out the ground. So I'm going to bash this one. It flattens it. See that? So let's demonstrate here. See that that ground there is a little lumpy? And it's all nice and, well, sort of flat. Flat-ish. It's getting it flat. It'll keep going flat. See that? Look at that. Isn't that cool? That's your sledgehammer. How wonderful. Makes the ground all nice and flat. Now, that can be useful for doing your entrances. Oh, it don't work on dirt, so it has to be stone. But you can sort of smoothen out. So you can make a cavern, a nice cavern with flat-ish floor. I'm not sure how much you'll use the sledgehammer, but I'm sure if you've got loads of bumpy ground around your mine, you can use this to make it nice. Look at that. Isn't that a beautiful entrance out? And then I can go for a swim straight after my mine, so it'll cool me down and wash all that sweat off. Isn't that cool? I need to next work on a nice entrance out, of course. But for now, there we go. That is what the sledgehammer will do for you. Quite cool, isn't it? Flattens it all down. There we go. Right, I'd better end the episode here because I've waffled on for far too long. and I'm going to have a bit of fun mining up this iron. Iron is very good, as you can see, with all the stuff you make with it. Wherever you are in the world, God bless you and keep every last one of you safe. Thank you for watching and have a fantastic day. Goodbye.